Thank you. standing. I don't know if you're supposed to be standing. This is my first time doing the call to worship. Amen, amen. And I even brought a few notes because I'm like, I don't want to mess this up. This is the most important part of the service. So God bless you all for being here this morning. I can tell you about some of my feelings about the call to worship. You know, I used to see it as, well, it's a time when I can make eye contact with people I haven't seen for a while, or everybody, the ushers, make sure they get seated. But then I thought about it. This is a time for us to connect with the Lord. And I don't know about you, but sometimes I come and, you know, I'm thinking, I know people are thinking about, oh, I got bills to pay, and I'm worried about my job. And I can tell you about me, I was thinking about a 16-year-old kid can't even ring the wrong doorbell, and he gets shot. And so I started thinking about all those things, and then I think, this is why we have a call to worship, because God needs our undivided attention. We serve a God who knows everybody in this room. He knows how many hairs are on our head, if for those of us that still have some. And sorry about that. And he is a God that is just so majestic. And he is worthy to be praised. So, and oh, when I look back and see all these beautiful women in the church, it's like, oh. So let's go in prayer. You see, I just forgot about my notes that God said, you don't need them. So please, let's go to the throne in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for allowing us to see another day. Lord, it is a present to be present. And we know that there are those who didn't make it. And Lord, we just pray that we will purge our thoughts of things that distract us from the worship. Let us worship in spirit and in truth. And let us, by everything we do today, show that we love you, Lord. And we dedicate ourselves to you today in this service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Stay on your feet and worship God with us. Can I use that same excuse that this is my first time too? It's an old song. Everybody know it. Go ahead and put your hands together and worship God with us.
I'm a soldier. good God.
Yes, he is.
I say that God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
I say my God is a holy God.
Yes, he is.
Oh, God is a holy God.
Yes, he is.
I say that God is a holy God.
Cause we need your presence.
Him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here at 2800 East 36th Street at Rising Star Missionary Baptist Church as we celebrate our annual Women's Day. Let's give it up for the sisters in the house. Hallelujah. Thank God for the women of God. Amen, amen, amen. And we praise God for those who have tuned in via live stream as well. You may be seated. Thank you so much for coming on today. This is the day that the Lord has made. Regardless of what you've been through this week, we're going to rejoice and be glad today. Amen. This is the new happy hour. Amen. 10 o'clock at Rising Star. Amen. We are glad to be in the house of the Lord on today. So good to see so many of you here as well. Amen. At this time, we want to welcome those of you who are in the building. Thank God that you're here. And we want to welcome those who are online via live stream. Amen. We ask that you share the live stream with family members and friends so they can tune in as well. And the good thing about having live stream, you can go back and see it again. Amen. 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 All right. But if you're in the building for the first time, we would like for you to stand so we can recognize you. You don't have to say anything. We just want you to stand real quick so we can give you a welcome packet. Amen. And make sure that you fill out that first impression card. All first-time guests, go ahead and stand. It's safe. It's safe. Go ahead and stand. It's safe. We won't hurt you. We won't bother you. Amen. All right. All right. Remain standing for a moment here. All right. They want to make sure you get that welcome package to you. Want to say to you that out of all the churches you could have gone to, you made the decision to come to Rising Star. We do not take that lightly. We trust and pray that you will be blessed as a result of fellowshipping with us on today. And also, if you're looking for a church home, we'd love to have you right here at Rising Star. We always tell people before you join a church, make sure you pray about it. Once you pray about it, then you know that's the place where the Lord will have you to serve. And remember that Rising Star is a church where everyone is welcome. Amen. We're a local church with a global reach. We are building a kingdom culture. Amen. Get in where you fit in. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. All right. Let's give it up for our guests. Let's give them a hand clap of praise for coming and being with us on today. I see a few people from the community. Good to see you in the house as well. God bless you. Amen. We just doing kingdom. Amen. We're keeping it kingdom. Amen. All right. We got a song for you because sometimes working in the church and dealing with church members and dealing with, you know, brothers and sisters in Christ, you know, this is a church family. And sometimes folks in the family act up. You need a little more Jesus. Come on, y'all. Let's just tell the truth and get delivered today. But the Jesus in me loves the Jesus in you. And that makes it easy, just a little bit easier to love. Next to you, did you introduce yourself? Did you say hi? Come on, let's not come to church and be stuck up now. Come on, amen. Speak to people, smile at folk. Come on, somebody, amen. This is the Lord's house, everybody's welcome. Amen, amen, amen. I would have all the women to stand on Women's Day, but the whole church would be standing, so y'all just stay seated. Amen. Amen. Look at our beautiful women's choir. Don't they look beautiful? Amen. And their pastel colors. Amen. Amen. We praise God for our women here at Rise and Star. Amen. I want to say thank you to those of you who made it out see banquet on last night. Amen. We had a great time, and we had a lot of Rising Star people doing things, and I appreciate you guys doing things not only in the church, but also in the community. Amen. You're being the salt of the earth and the light of the world. So thank you for your service, not only in the church, but also in the community. Amen. We said that Rising Star is a leadership training center. Amen. We bring them in, train them up, and we send them out. Amen. That's what we're trying to do. All right. So let me look at the prayer list here real quick. We want to keep these individuals in mind on today as we pray. First of all, I want to see the slide for Mother Carr. We had her memorial service on yesterday. 93 years old. What a classic woman of God. And we are dedicating this Women's Day service to her. Amen. In honor of her. And isn't it just, it's not ironic or a coincidence, I think it's providence, that her niece, Evangelist Elliott, gonna be preaching today on Women's Day. God has a way of hooking things up. Amen. 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 So this service is dedicated to her. Amen. On today, we want you to remember Tanisha Bland. Her grandmother is making her transition. Shirley Martin is her mother, but her grandmother is making her transition. So let's be in prayer for the Martin family. Amen. Also continue to pray for the Carr family, because we know when the service is over, the grieving is not over. It's a process. So be in prayer for them. Also be in prayer for the Carter family. We're going to do the memorial service for Sister Joyce Carter this coming Saturday here at Rising Star at 11 o'clock. The interment will be at East Lawn. Then we'll come back to the church for the repast. And I want to thank Reverend Pete Cordell, amen, for helping us to put all that together, as well as Deacon Rex Kinsey. Amen. I really appreciate you guys' help. Amen. Making my load just a little bit lighter as the pastor. Amen. Also, we want to be in prayer for Deacon Dean. He's in TMC, so let's continue to lift him up in prayer. We want to be in prayer also for Sister Vonzia Jackson. I heard that she's transitioning into hospice care. He's at. Okay, so keep that in mind as well. Elder Marshall let me know that his cousin is being transferred to Salt Lake City, Utah. He has some heart complications, and they don't think he's going to make it, but we know that God is a God that will hear and answer prayers. Not over until he says it's over. Amen? Amen. Amen. So please keep all these individuals in prayer. Also, Deacon McFarland, we're going to keep your daughter Samantha in prayer as well. Thank you for sharing that with me on last week. I know our sister Nicole Patton, she had some outpatient surgery done last week. We want to continue to remember her in prayer. Also, Elder Cook has sent a request for her nephew, Ronald Wimbush. Amen. So many prayer requests we have, and that's why we keep saying you need to be connected to a cell group, Sunday school, Bible study, so people can get to know you and you get to know them, so we can pray for one another and be there for one another, okay? All right, let's talk about the T-shirt design contest that's coming up. All right, you see the information there. I don't need to repeat it. Amen, but we're looking forward to a new T-shirt. I don't know about you, but I need a whole drawer in my dresser set aside just for T-shirts. Amen. Amen. So we praise God for the T-shirt contest. So that's the information. And then they have a bowling event coming up for the fifth Sunday, which is next Sunday. Amen. So go ahead and make sure that you take care of whatever you need to take care of so that you can go and be part of that celebration over at the bowling center. Amen. All right. Lucky Strike Bowl. All right. Next announcement, Bright Star distribution will be on the 26th of April from 4:30 to 6 o'clock p.m. Again, Bright Star distribution, food distribution will be on the 26th, okay, from 4:30 to 6 o'clock p.m. All right. Mission Sunday is coming up next Sunday. We ask those who are willing and able to give $35 above and beyond what you normally do so we can support our projects, our mission projects, those projects locally and globally. And our very own evangelist, Dean Collins. Amen. She's going to be bringing a word. Powerful woman of God. Amen. Then graduation Sunday is coming up as well. That will be on the 21st of May. Amen. And Dr. Tanya Strosch is going to be our speaker. But you need to get your information in as soon as possible if you want to participate, okay? Because once the deadline has hit, it is over, okay? So make sure that you get your paperwork in if you want to be part of the graduation Sunday celebration, all right? All right. Mother's Day's brunch. All right. Fish fry. May the 13th. From 12 to 2, just don't show up, sign up. And show up, all right? And they're going to take care of you. All right, so those are announcements for this morning. I think we have a video for you at this time. God bless you.
The body of Christ is a community deliberately nurturing the next generation. And women play a pivotal role in that sacred trust. Godly women in the church are called to teach and train younger women. Titus chapter 2, verses 3 through 5. We are familiar with the woman described in Proverbs 31. She is clothed with strength and dignity and loves the Lord. You are definitely just that. People often ask, did women serve in the Bible? Well, Phoebe is identified as Paul's benefactor, a term that literally means defender or protector. She also used her money and influence to help the missionaries fulfill their calling. Others, like Prisca, Romans chapter 16, verse 5, and Lydia, Acts chapter 16, verse 14, volunteered their homes for the advancement of ministry. These remarkable and brave sisters set the standard that remains the blueprint today. We are grateful for the spirit-filled women who serve God with joy and gladness here at Rising Star. Your presence makes a difference in countless lives across the world. So on this Women's Day, we celebrate you. Yes, you. The strong, saved, and spirit-led soul that God protects each and every day. We love you, and happy Women's Day.
Amen. Can we all stand for prayer? And this is that time that we really center ourselves and focus on a God who is so good. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for allowing us to see another day. Lord, it's a gift to be present. Lord, we thank you for those who have come to worship in spirit and in truth. And And Lord, we pray for those who are unable to make it because maybe they're sick. Maybe they're incarcerated. Maybe they're lost. Whatever it is, the one thing we know is we serve a true God who is with us wherever we are. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you. And Lord, we pray for the bereaved this morning. We pray for those who are just struggling just to make it, Lord, as the prices of food goes up, as just the cost of living is making it so unbearable for people, Lord. And it's a blessing. Help us to be a blessing to others who need our help, Lord. And Lord, we thank you for the women of this church. Lord, we know what women mean to our worship. We know what the women mean to our service. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for blessing Rising Star with amazing women, Lord. Women of God who serve you, who love you. We thank you. We thank you for our First Lady who models grace and kindness. And Lord, we thank you for a pastor who doesn't mind putting a woman in the pulpit, Lord, and let women preach the gospel. Who doesn't mind putting women in leadership roles, Lord, because he knows that God is a God of both men and women, Lord. So we thank you for our pastor. And Lord, we thank you for our speaker this morning. Lord, we know that she is an anointed woman of God, and we look forward to the message that you have given her, Lord. And Lord, we pray for our nation this morning. Lord, there's so much meanness and vitriol and people fighting, and we just thank you that Rising Star is a church where everyone is welcome. We don't care who you are, Lord, because we know all souls are precious in your sight. And Lord, we ask you to forgive us of our sins. Lord, we know that none of us are sinless, and we thank you for Jesus, Lord, who has brought grace and mercy for us. And Lord, we just love you. We just can't say enough how much we love you, Lord. And we just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. In thy name we pray. Amen. I think you may be seated. Right? Okay. Okay. So it is offering time. Now, I'm going to say, usually when we say it's offering time, everybody go, yay, which is a good thing. But I thought I'd add a few things this morning about offering time. First of all, I wanted to focus on some reasons that I think we give. We give because of gratitude. We give because of trust. And we give because of love. So speaking of gratitude, I want to share some statistics with you. This past week contained 7 days, 168 hours, 10,080 minutes, 604,800 seconds. In the United States, on average, over 60,000 people die weekly. Guess what? You are here. You are not one of those statistics. Praise the Lord. We are here. And then we trust. We trust God because he knows everything we are going through, every moment, every time of the day. He knows the future. He knows what's best for us, even if we don't always follow what he tells us to do. So we know, Lord, that we need to follow his path and trust that he knows us because we know he loves us. And then speaking of love, God's love for us will never die. Once again, there is nothing, absolutely nothing we can do to make God stop loving us. So when we think of gratitude, when we think of, what was my self? Trust. And we think of love, then that should determine our giving. What else could be possible? Now, we can give in four ways. Please put it up on it. Thank you. You all pray for me. You know, I'm one of God's children learning. So we can give through Zelle, which is the preferred way. We can give online. We can give through snail mail or in the back of the church. We can give in one of those containers there. But whatever it is, give according to your heart. Dear Lord, we just thank you. Thank you, Lord, for those who open their hearts and minds and give this morning. Lord, we pray for those who are not able to give. But Lord, if they can't give tithes, they can tithe their time to the Lord. And Lord, we just thank you for just being a loving God who loves us. And you, Lord, just showed us what generosity means. You showed us when you sent your son, Jesus. So we thank you, Lord. And we pray for all the gifts this morning that they will uplift your kingdom, that they will uplift this church. In Jesus' name, amen.
Introducing our Praise Dance Ministry, who are going to minister to you today. And they're going to minister the goodness of God by C.C. Winans. And it says, I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days, I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your goodness is running after me. Amen.
Good morning. In honor of Women's Day, I wrote a short poem about what a woman means to me. A woman is a warrior. She is of great strength and passion. A woman perseveres through the storms, showing complete trust in God to get her through struggles. A woman is outstanding, for without her, there would be nothing. A woman is my God-fearing mother, who is a business owner. A woman is a beautiful creation of God, for she is fearfully and wonderfully made. A woman is mighty. She is my greatest grandmother from the motherland, whose skin is the mother of all skin. For God will give her a purpose, so when she walks, it is with tenacity. A woman is admired. She is a graceful and kind woman. A woman is my great-grandmother, who taught my mother how to do hair. She commands the room with her beauty and elegance, just like my grandmother. A woman is of nobility, for she is a queen in the kingdom of God. Thank you.
Good morning, church, and beautiful women of Rising Star, and all the rest of you as well. Okay. I'm about to introduce a woman to you today that needs no introduction to God because he knows her. More importantly, she knows him. And he is the reason that she is here. This woman is well acquainted with pain, loss, and adversity. But that makes her qualified to preach the pleasures of God, to preach gain in spite of loss, and the victory of becoming a kingdom overcomer. This mighty woman of God who is about to stand before you and proclaim the unadulterated truth of God has figuratively walked through hell wearing gasoline garments. She has been ordained by man, but more than that, she has been ordained by God. And I am Holy Ghost proud to call her my prayer warrior, to call her my life's mentor, to call her the evangelist. And she is my friend. I've seen her snatch stuff off her head to praise God. I've seen her praise her eyelashes off. Hallelujah. Because this woman knows God. So after this upcoming selection, the next voice that you will hear will be that of God's relentless warrior, the mighty evangelist, Doretta Elliott.
Good morning, y'all. Y'all know I don't do a whole lot of public speaking, but I just wanted to say thank you to this women's choir, the women's ministry that always think of me. I know it's always has a tough job for me, but they make it easy, and God makes it easier. So it's an oldie, but a goodie. So come on and sing with us.
Trouble don't last always. trouble don't last.
Trouble don't last always.
I'm so glad.
I'm so glad.
Yeah, yes I am. Trouble don't last always.
Trouble don't last always.
He may not come when you want him.
Yeah.
But he's on time. Life. I know he'll be there. Yes, he will.
Be there.
Every one of your burdens, I know the Lord will help you to bear.
Be there. I'm so glad.
Come on, put your hands together. Trouble don't last always. Don't last always.
Don't last always.
We've been there.
We've been there.
In your
heart,
I
keep the faith.
Keep the faith.
It will be all
right. We've been there.
We've been there.
In your
heart, I
keep the faith.
Keep the faith. It will be
y'all trouble. Can I get a witness in the building?
We'll be right back.
Women's Day. And of all days, as Pastor said, if you all didn't know, a lot of you didn't know. You know, Cynthia and I just say, hello, cousin, just to say hello, cousin. Our mothers are sisters. So I thank God that on this day, we get to honor women, we get to honor her memory. And guess what? I had a laughing at the funeral yesterday. Now that my aunt is gone, it leaves me as the matriarch of the family. We never know when we're sitting before our elders and listening. And now I got to carry on those stories. So I want to encourage someone. Listen to the stories. Respect your elders. Be there and learn from them. The pastor said yesterday, it's so ironic. Our whole family, the DNA is giving, sharing, always in all of our lives, all my life, we've always been giving and sharing. So I want somebody to catch that. I want that to be contagious. If I don't give you anything else, I'm going to give you a good dose of Jesus and a good dose of caring about somebody else. In the name of Jesus. We've come this far by faith, leaning on the Lord. I know we're trusting is a good God. And I don't know about you, but I got a story to tell. And I don't know about your story, but I've come this far by faith. Our scripture, please. Our scripture will come from Luke, the 8th chapter, verses 43 through 48. And a woman having an issue of blood 12 years, which had spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed of any, came behind him and touched the border of his garment. And immediately her issue of blood stanched. And Jesus said, who touched me? When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed against thee, and sayest thou, who touched me? And Jesus said, somebody has touched me. For I perceive that virtue is gone out of me. And when the woman saw that she was not hid, she came trembling and falling down before him. And she declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him. And how? She was healed immediately. And he said unto her, daughter, be of good comfort. Thy faith has made thee whole. Go in peace. You may be seated. Most holy and righteous Father, the giver of every good and perfect gift, I stop right now, God, in humble submission to your will and to your way, God, asking that you would use me as never before. God, I stand before you as an empty pitcher before a full fountain. Fill me, oh God. Fill me up, God. Use me for your glory, God. I have nothing to say to your people, God, but everything comes from you. An anointed word all the way from on high, God. Anoint these clay lips that you give me, oh God, because I've come to give you glory. I want you to have the praise. God, get your honor that you do today, oh God. Truly, you are worthy. In the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray and ask it all. Amen and amen. I sure want to thank y'all for being here today. Well, I preached this already in my sleep, so I could just say ditto. Well, let me tell you something. On last Saturday, Reverend McDowell
she was on to say a few words. I told her I was going to get her there and just drop the mic and say, ditto. She tore that up. But let me tell you what God gave me. So many times when we see this scripture, we see these passages, wait a minute, what's wrong with you, girl? Pastor, thank you. Thank you for allowing me to preach. Thank you. He is so humble. You know, some men, as the young lady says, dating young lady. Go on, Daisy. You see that day? Young lady Daisy's here. As Daisy said. So many, I'm serious. I've been in a lot of churches. Men don't want you to preach. They don't want you saying anything. Even if you are another man in their church, they're covetous of their pulpit. So thank you for your humble spirit. Thank you for allowing God to use us, to use our gift. And to our first lady, the first lady this side, the best first lady this side of heaven. Not in Tucson, this side of heaven. Uh-huh. All the rest of them gone. Okay. I just want you to know there's none to compare to you. For 20 years, you all need to know that I was a pastor's wife. And where did I learn to be a pastor's wife from? Bam. Because she was my pastor's wife for years. So when I married a pastor, I know how to act. Don't stir up no stuff in the church. Y'all know how many pastors' wives mess up for the pastor? I'm going to tell y'all it's the truth. A whole lot of pastors are not in their church. What cause of them? They gossiping wife. Mm-hmm. They wife with them two little clothes on. Their wife that's doing everything but being a pastor's wife, being submissive and letting God use her. Because really, it don't just go to him. Can I tell you for sure? When I was a pastor's wife, you can't, and your kids too. It's like you're in a box, you're in a glass house. It's the truth. You can't be the pastor of your kids around town doing in and everything and all this. The pastor's wife is a very, very important part of it. And I learned it from you, and I thank you. Ah, God is an awesome God. Y'all already know that. But for those of you that didn't, I'm sure going to let you know today. As we look at this scripture today, faith. Our title is faith, faith to believe in the midst of your situation. You know that midst, right smack dab in the middle, that midst of your situation. You know, for so long, things happen in the church. I don't know about y'all, but I gotta tell y'all about me. When I got into the church, y'all know I'm a founding member, 46 years, rising star. Look. But can I tell you, I wasn't always the evangelist. Mm-hmm. Can I just tell y'all the truth? I love to do that. Y'all know that dance they do, the church hokey pokey. Y'all know that, right? What? Yes, y'all do. Y'all don't act like y'all don't know the church hokey pokey. Look here. Y'all know that. Y'all know that. Well, here's how the church hokey pokey go. You go to church on Sunday morning. You go to club on Saturday night. Y'all know the church hokey pokey, right? I just want to let y'all know, somebody need to know, you can stand and get saved for real. Look, you go to church on Sunday morning, you hit the club on Saturday night. You start to read your Bible and you want to get it right. You give your life to Jesus, he turn you all around. That's what it's all about. Get delivered. Y'all thought y'all didn't know the church hokey pokey. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Baby, I had a whole new dance. I got that cabbage patch for Jesus. What? Hey! Brother Mathis used to crack up. I'd be the only young person that would, look, stay around the fire. I'd be the only young person there on East on sunrise service. But you know what? I stayed there long enough till I got it real. I was faking and shaking, but now I got it, y'all. And I got to tell somebody else, get him for real. When you're having for real in your life, there's nothing like it. Hallelujah. Our sermon today is about faith. So many times, and God, y'all, can I ever tell y'all I'm not quite that smart? I tell y'all every time, I'm not quite as smart as I look. I know I look smart, but I'm not quite that smart. But God gave me the word faith. I had to speak at a church one time to another women's conference. I said, God, what would you have me to tell them? He said, faith. F-A-I-T-H. So, okay, now I can spell it. Okay. He said, faith, favor already in the house. Ooh. What? I told y'all I'm not that that smart? God told me to tell y'all that. His favor is already in the house. F-A-I-T-A. You know what we do sometimes? Ooh, I sure want some cake. Ooh, I sure want a cake. Ooh, I don't feel like... Guess what? You got some eggs in your house, some milk, some flour. So guess what? The cake is already in the house, but you got to put it together. That's the way your faith is. It's already in here, but we're not using it. We're not putting it together. So God wants me to tell somebody. So many times when we hear this sermon, when we hear this part of scripture, we think about the woman and her illness. We don't want to concentrate on that today. I want you to concentrate on her faith. Not how long she was sick, but how great her faith was while she had it. Hallelujah. Verse 43 says, and a woman having an issue of blood 12 years has spent all her living upon physicians, neither could be healed of any. Y'all know how God messed with me with those letters too, right? Y'all know. Today he's giving me the letter D. So the first D is she was destitute. Well, I need to tell you, first of all, this is a story within a story. If you really look at that 8th chapter of Luke, the story starts out with a Jairus coming to Jesus and said, look, my daughter is sick. Could you come and help her? She's sick unto death. She's dying. And Jesus is going on with Jairus, and bam, here comes a lady with the issue of blood and touch. Hey, what's happening here? You see what I said? Faith in the midst of your situation. Sometimes when you're on your way doing something else, life just going to, in the middle of trying to do right, in the middle of trying to do what God has asked you to do, bam, something else happens. You better be ready. God wants you to know anything can happen at any time. This woman was sick 12 long years with a sickness. A woman with an issue. If you had an issue, honey, you was an outcast. You couldn't go nowhere. People didn't want to be around you, don't want you around them. This woman was, wait a minute. What about the man with the issue of blood? Oh, so there she go with her crazy self. Oh, the man with the issue of blood. Listen to this. On November the 7th, 1991, I believe his name was Irvin Magic Johnson. I believe he got up and told the whole wide world that he had AIDS. I believe that nobody wanted to play basketball with him. Nobody wanted to go in the locker room with him. Nobody wanted him anywhere near because they was afraid of Irvin Magic Johnson. They were scared of AIDS. Didn't know what AIDS was all about. That's how that woman felt. Ostracized. You know, you got to take some of the old stories and put them in today. You know he had to quit playing basketball? Because nobody wanted to be around him. They were afraid of him. And in the midst of you trying to do what you do, trying to do you, somebody's looking at you saying, mm-mm. Don't want nothing to do with him. Mm-mm. But this woman was destitute, y'all. She spent all her money trying to get well, trying to get it right. Destitute. I mean, without any basic need or necessity. Ain't nobody coming over. You need anything today, Shirley? You want anything, Mary? Uh-uh. They weren't coming. And people will do you like that in life. In life, they were your friends. They had your back. They don't now. She was destitute. You know what else she was? That other dick. She was disgraced. It was a sin, a law. You could come, no one, if they wanted to visit her, couldn't come near her for fear of them being labeled unclean. Unclean. You know, some of us need to be walking around. Thank God. God don't make us do that now. Walking somewhere, unclean. You had to yell it before you got there. Unclean. Folks have to just make way, get away from you. Whew. If we had to yell out what we do now, we'd be messed up, wouldn't we? I don't know about y'all, but I'm do like the deaf ministry. I ain't gonna say it, I'm just gonna sign it. Mm-mm. But you know what else she was? She was discouraged. Don't y'all sit, y'all know I get mad, go to Macy's, got all my money. What? That's just your money shopping and you watch the stuff yourself. But suppose you spent all your money on somebody who said they were gonna help you, somebody who said they're gonna make you better, but she said she was no better. But matter of fact, she got worse. She still had it. 12 years, that's a lot of money. That's a lot of time. But you know what else it is? A lot of heartache. A lot of hurt. A lot of frustration. But we see the sickness. I want you to see the woman. We see the 12 years of an issue. See the woman with the issue. Mm. Jesus. So many times we get caught up on that story with just she was sick. She was. She was. And I believe the reason it doesn't have a name there is because it could be any woman. It says Jairus, the ruler. Don't it say that? It gives his name. He was a man of importance, big in the synagogue, a ruler of the synagogue. He'd go there and read the scriptures on Saturday and doing this and that. But guess what? It doesn't give her a name. It could be any one of us, man or woman. I just told you that, didn't I? Yes. Magic had an issue. He wasn't no woman. And it was an issue of blood. Same thing. So don't get caught up on, like, that only happened to a woman. It can happen to anybody. Mm. Verse 44 says, and came behind him, came behind Jesus, and touched the border of his garment. And immediately, the issue of blood stopped. It stopped. Do y'all hear me? That's the kind of God we serve. And in verse 44, the D is she was desperate. Desperate means she's in a hopeless situation. I told you what she had to do. Nobody coming. You got to go get water. You got to get stuff for her. Nobody coming to help her. She was desperate, lonely, 12 years. Guess what? You go to the doctor's office and the whole place clear out because you in there. Because you couldn't sit anywhere next to him. You couldn't let him touch you. You couldn't do it because then you became unclean. Nobody going to let them touch you. How you feel doing it everywhere you go? Folks shun you. God, we have to think of she was. See, desperate times call for desperate measures. You see, sometimes we get desperate, whether it's financially, morally, spiritually, physically. What would you do when you get in some situations? What would you do? You know, I'm reminded of the story in 2018, in June, it was in Thailand. I believe that was 12, there they go, that number 12, 12 young boys and their coach was stuck in a cave. Y'all remember that? No, some of them folk quit praying. No, they didn't. Where were the mothers? Where were those fathers? At the mouth of that cave, yet praying. Your children stuck in there all that time. You better have some faith. You better know how to call. Now, they may not, I won't be honest with you. They may not have been calling on God. They was calling on something. But let me tell you, I call on God. I'll just tell you. Faith. You've got to have faith in God for what you're calling on and believe that. The Bible says a grain of mustard. People say, I got faith size of mustard. It don't say that. You don't even have the whole seed. The grain of the mustard seed. You didn't got to have the whole seed. And that's the tiniest seed there is. But we'd have to learn to believe what we're saying. Say to that mountain, be moved. Whatever your mountain is. Finances, bad kids, woo, Jesus. Whatever your mountain is, job, somebody messing with you at work, whatever your mountain is, say to that mountain. You know we say things, look here, let me tell you something. If I need to borrow $10, what do I have to do to let you know I need $10? I gotta call you and ask you and tell you I need $10. We want God to work out stuff. Where you asked him? Haven't called him. Haven't talked to him. He don't know because you didn't ask him. I read a book called When God Doesn't Answer Prayer. It said the most reason, number one reason prayers are not answered, we don't ask him. We just assume he just said, let me wait. She gonna ask me sooner or later. No, you're not. Open your mouth and say something. As the song says, open your mouth and say something. God, I need you. And I need you like never before. I tried this on my own, God. It's not working. I went to my cousin. She can't help me. I went to the loan officer. He said no. I went to the bank. They said no. I went to the school. They talked about putting them in special ed. I went over there, God, and they told them my credit was no good. I went, guess what? God can fix all of that. Whatever your mountain is, say to the mountain, my God will supply all my needs. Hallelujah. Sit up there with your mouth closed and God got just what you need. I'm finna get mad now. And I want you, you know what I want while I'm mad? I want y'all to quit playing with God like he's, let's make a deal. Yeah, they do. course I did too. Just like that church hokey pokey. I know what y'all doing because I did it. Sister, God, if you do this, I'm going to stop doing that. God, if you just, I'm going to stop. No, you're not. Quit lying. Do right because it's right to do right. How's that for do right? Mm-hmm. We got so many excuses. I would do right, but I would, but ain't no but God. Stop playing. Every time you get in some trouble, yeah, God, I'm going. As soon as the problem over, you know, forgot all about God. Can't find you. You don't even say nothing to God. Nothing. Stop playing with God like he's let's make a deal. He's not. Your problem is real. So is he. I never forget when my husband had prostate cancer. They said, well, you know, my cousin had it and it looked like something, and it looked like something. I said, what? Did you say it looked like? Looked like that's what's going to happen with your husband. Looked like that. I said, excuse me, I don't serve a look like God. I serve a real God with real answers. And when I need him, he's really there. And maybe it don't come out the way you want it to come out, but it comes out. God hears us, and he answers prayer. Are you listening to him? He's listening to you. Verse 45 says, and Jesus said, who touched me? When all denied, Peter and they that were with him said, Master, the multitude thronged thee and pressed thee, and sayest thou, who touched me? The next D is discernment. You want to perceive, who touched you? I think Peter, if they had to put the D, they would say, duh. Now, Jesus, Master, Teacher, look here. Now you see all these people around you. They're about to knock us over trying to get to you. And you're going to ask us who touched you? That'd be like, look. That'd be like going to Walmart on Black Friday. Y'all know how it is. Oh, guess y'all never been. Let me tell you how it is. Like you're trying to run to the TV section because they only got four of them. Look, they got look, 500 people in the line. Girl, they got TVs at Walmart. That girl, 60-inch, gonna be $100. Everybody and their cousins all from Marana, all around, go over that four TVs. Look, and then they open the door, and you rush in, so who touched me? How do I know who touched you? I'm trying to get to the TV. So Peter and them looking like, duh, Master, okay. He said, when somebody really touches you, I want you to see this now. When somebody really touches you, you know it. There's some people who have spoken to your life and they touch you, not your physical touch. That's what Jesus does. He touches you and you'll never be the same. But what I like about this is, when he said, who touched me, you need to know that Jesus took his time and cares about each and every one of us. A whole lot of people were touching him, but when you touch him, when you need him, when it's something you need from God, and you touch him with your faith, something happens. He knows you touched him. That's more important. You know you touched him. But let me tell you something. We see Jesus, but more than that, he sees us. He sees that we are real. He sees that we know what we're talking about. He sees that we trust him. And if you don't trust him, honey, shut your mouth. Ain't no need you your prayer ain't getting no farther than these lights. I don't play with y'all. I'm telling y'all the truth today. Stop playing with God. Y'all know how I know. I did it long enough. So God says, stop playing with folks. Tell them the truth. You need Jesus, and baby, you need him in a bad way. I did, and you do too. Stop doing that dance. Get your new partner. I got Jesus. So many times we're just going through the motion. God wants us to be real in him. When you know better, we ought to do better. When you know better, what happens? All right, y'all said it. Y'all got it now. Don't give God no excuses then. Verse 46 says, and Jesus said, somebody has touched me, for I perceive that virtue is gone out of me. But I tell you, when you touch him, he knows. So why would Jesus say, who touched me? What in the world? You know why? Because he was human and a God side. At that point, his humanity was there. His humanity was among the people. And he really didn't know who touched me. But he knew somebody had touched him, and he felt the power of God. Not the power, dunamis power, but power morally, spiritually. He felt that, his human side. And he didn't know who touched him because all the people were there. But when he got into his divinity, he knew to help the young lady. He knew that she believed in him. He knew that she'd been going through something. And do you know he knows that about you? When you get sincere with God, she knew that she could be stoned. She knew she could be killed. She knew. Y'all been in some stuff and in some places you weren't. Oh, I guess I'm the only one ever been in some places you weren't supposed to be in. Baby, I could roll out a window in a minute. Shut up! You hear something? Who is that? Oh, I wonder I was the good evangelist sitting up here. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Girl, I got in some stuff. My girlfriend used to say, girl, you slick as snake oil. Let me tell you something about that. When you get it together and you get it right, y'all know the title of my first sermon I ever preached? Returning to the Scene of the Crime. Because it was a sin and a shame, all the stuff I did, thought I was getting away with something. You know what I did? And this is what you ought to do. I'm going to tell y'all right now. Write this down. Whatever you used to do, and them friends you used to hang out with, doing whatever you thought you were doing, go back and tell them the truth. Go back and tell them, I got God in my life now. I'm sorry for all that I did. All that I thought I was big enough doing in front of y'all, I'm sorry. It was wrong. I need to tell you it was wrong. I was in Hobbs, New Mexico. Look here. My husband was pastoring in Hobbs, New Mexico. And I sat there that day, and the Spirit convicted me. I have a best friend. Her name is Roslyn. Her name is Roslyn Longmire. She's Roslyn Hunter. She thought I was slick. What? She thought the sun rose and set on me. Slick as snake oil, she told. What? Guess what I did? I said, honey, we need to go to Tucson. He said, yeah, babe, we're going next week. No, honey, we need to go now. He said, baby, I need to talk to Roz. I need to tell her the truth. I need to tell her that all those things I was doing I thought was funny, we laughed about, that ain't funny anymore. Amen. I got God and I got him right in my life. I need to go tell him. That's my best friend. I ain't letting her go down like that. I got him and I got him right. I got to go. Guess what? Y'all know, that did tell y'all Rosalind Longmire. Did I tell y'all right now her name was Pastor Rosalind Longmire? You don't know what you do for people. I came back and I had to tell her the truth. All that jucking and running and all that we was doing, honey, that was all in vain. Only thing I hate about being a Christian, you know what I hate about being a Christian? That I gave the devil too much of my time. But when you get it right, go back and tell somebody. You know, when you make a good old cake or peach cobbler or something, you know you call some girl, I knocked that, girl, you got to taste this peach cobbler. Girl, I look up, sometimes I make something so good, I look up and say, sorry, mama, this is better than yours. Look, I don't want to hurt your feelings in heaven, mama, but you didn't make it like this. One time, a pitcher fell off the wall, I got scared too. Look, I hope that was just a coincidence. So many times, we get something good. Y'all know how we do, ladies? A good sale. We call everybody. Girl, you better get to Macy's. They got some shoes on. Girl, did you hear about this sale? Girl, we do all of that. We pass mess around. Uh-huh. Stuff costs you money. Pass Jesus around. I'm going to ask y'all to get real with Jesus. pass them around. Your friends that you was doing this, that, whatever with them, go tell them the truth. Amen. Tell them about a real Savior. Look, I'm fixing to go too. I need to get me a cane and a walker when I say it. Look, I am fixing to go to my 50th class reunion. Here, one of my class, stand up, Sylvia. This is my classmate, Sylvia. She heard I was preaching today. Look at my friend. Look, let me tell y'all something. I'm getting ready to go to my 50th class reunion. And when they heard at first, I told them, I said, y'all not going to see. I was a class, pastor, tell you, he told me one time, girl, I think you maybe you might have missed your calling. I think you should have been a comedian. But let me tell y'all something. When I first sat down, I told them, I was crazy. But I was number 13 in my class, too, now, out of 472. Now, I was crazy, but I know my mom going to whoop my tail if I didn't bring no A's and B's home. Look. So, when I went to the reunion, the first time I was talking to them, hey, Dorena, you still crazy? Are you still there just laughing? I said, y'all better sit down. They said, what? They thought I was going to tell them I had cancer or something. Y'all better sit down. I said, y'all need to know that I'm married to a preacher. They killed themselves laughing. Girl, quit! I said, stay seated. Don't get up. I said, I'm a preacher too. One of them fell off the chair. I said, girl, no, you're not no preacher. Oh no! I said, when I got through talking, did y'all believe me, Sylvia? When you get through talking and people see the change in your life, when they see what God has done for you. And so many times we leave people in the dark. Let me tell y'all what we do. We separate our church friends from our others. Put all the boogers together. Make you a big old dinner. Bite the sinners and the saints. Sinners like peach cobbler. Yeah, they do. I know I did when I was sitting. I like peach cobbler. Let me tell y'all something. So many times we try to do the separate. Let God do it. Just don't beat nobody. You know what? A lot of men that are some women married, whoever, and your husband don't come to church, they go, and I told him, if he read that Bible, and if he did that, stop beating your husband over the head with the Bible. That ain't going to save him. It's going to make him run. Here's what you do. If you got somebody, I don't care if your husband, cousin, nephew, in your life, you want to go, model Jesus for them. Act right in front of them. Do what you're supposed to do in front of them. That'll get them there before any Bible beating. God is such a good God. He uses us. And Mr. T, I still call him Mr. T, Terry Thomas, he laughed. He said, I love when it's your day to preach. You gotta tell all your business from the pulpit. You're so crazy. I said, I know it. He said, you're your same crazy. And you know what? And if God should bless you, don't be trying to be so, and God said, those chosen. I don't want to hear all of that fake stuff. Just be yourself. I'm crazy out there. And I didn't change once I hit the two steps. That didn't change me. But God did. And I used that same Doretta that I had to tell you how good he is to me. I need to tell you where he brought me from. I need to tell you if he delivered me, by God, he can deliver you. Sitting up there, praying. Look at here. That's my son. Reggie, stand up. I used you too. You see this? Sit down now. See, he's an obedient boy. Look at that obedient child. Don't y'all want one of those? Take him. Look, let me tell you something. And he know I'm going to tell his story. Every mother had to listen. You know how they get when they're young, going to do what they're going to do. I told y'all about that Sunday. I said, maybe that was graduation. I said, y'all son or daughter may have graduated, magna cum laude, summa laude. But my Reggie, he graduated, thank you, Laude. Look here. I'm gonna tell you something. Arizona Department of Corrections. Y'all know what I'm talking about? Yeah. I don't like orange to this day. Let me tell y'all something though. Never give up on your child. Yeah. God is so good. Can I tell you something? Desperate situations make you do some desperate things. You know how I learned how to fast? When my son went to prison. You know how he learned how to fast? When he went to prison. I ain't saying it to be funny. I'm telling you that some things come in your life you're trying to get rid of, God want to do a new thing in you. He wants to see where your faith is in him. I had never fasted in my life. But baby, I turned that plate down when my baby was in that little cell over there. I had to learn. And sometimes things happen to us. 12 years, 5 years, whether it's 10 minutes, 3 weeks, whatever it is, trust God. Give it to God. I prayed and prayed. I get a letter saying, Mama, Nana, that's my mama. They call my mama Nana. I want you to know that I'm sorry I'm in here. That God has shown me that I'm wrong. I'm so sorry. You know what he called himself? I'm the black sheep of the family. You better not say that no more. You are sheep, but you better get that sheep stuff right. Follow after God. I don't allow him to say it now. But guess who sends out the scriptures in the morning now? Guess who got it right? Guess who loved God? Guess who? You never give up on your child. You never know who it's going to be. Y'all see him sitting there crying. We teach them it's okay to cry. It's okay to do it. But now, look at God. So many people give up on people. Look at God. Hallelujah. Exercise your faith. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Verse 46, and Jesus said, somebody touched him. When virtue went out of him, he knew it. And when you get it right and you do right, God is, the angels are just shouting in heaven. When he wrote me that letter, honey, I told people, honey, you may have gotten a letter from the governor, but you ain't got no letter like I got from my Reggie. He got his life together. He teaching Bible study in the Hoosgow. And you look around and I start thinking, this boy played the drums at the Little Rising Star. So never, hey, don't forget where we came from. When you realize how many people got kids that won't visit them, don't talk to them, don't call me, got yourself, you better not give up on your child. The devil waiting on him. The Muslims are waiting on him, trying to convert him to, I'm telling you what I know. You better not give up on your child. You better not give up on your situation, whatever that is. Who are you to tell somebody they never gonna change? You know, folk did that. Girl, I said, you know, Richard's in Bible study. Said, yeah, honey, that's that jailhouse religion. Y'all know how they do. Make you try to give up on your own child. Whatever your situation is, it ain't your situation. You don't have my faith. You don't know my God. You don't know what he's done for me already. God is a mighty God. He's an awesome God. He's been so good to us. God wants to see, and all of us to see, that he has the answer today. As Jairus was going, I told you we're in the middle of the story. Jesus was going with him. The woman came, touched him. Jairus is like, how many of y'all would have said that? Hey, Master, what about me and my daughter? Weren't you going with me to, you see Jairus say, Jesus, no. They come up to Jairus and say, don't trouble the Master anymore. Your daughter is dead. Jesus looked at him and said, only believe. In the midst of your situation, it may look like it's dead. It may look like your situation, you're not going to get that job. You're not even qualified. Y'all ain't going to get that house. Y'all ain't got enough money. Only believe. Sometime in the middle of things, somebody trying to discourage you, trying to tell you that ain't going to happen. Girl, you'll never be moved up in your job. You think you're gonna be the supervisor? What? You better listen to God. You better pray and get it right. You know, a whole lot of folks have been talked out of their blessing. But listen to other folks. Usually they're jealous. Usually they don't want you to get, or they don't know how to handle promotion, don't want you to get up there either. Scared you'll change. But guess what? They changed. Because if that's really your friend, they're happy for you. If that's really someone who's sowing into your life, they're glad that you're moving on up. I tell people, if God is blessing so-and-so next door, I mean, he in the neighborhood. Maybe your turn next. Don't be mad at me because I got a new cat? Be happy for being fluffy. I'm telling you that. You know, let me tell you this while I'm talking. What I love about here at Rising Star, the women's ministry, the women in the ministry. So many times, I'm going to tell y'all, my husband was a pastor, 20 years, married to a pastor. Women in ministry, us preachers, evangelists, whatever, are so jealous of each other. Cat fighting all the time. At this church, honey, we like sickle to a dog. Get up there. So when it's D's turn, get him, girl. When Reverend McDowell said, get him, girl. We ain't got time to be fighting and bickering and fussing. I'm so proud of them. Like she said, I am so proud of her. I am so proud of you. I miss Donna Walker today. I miss that. We said to each other, sick him. Get him, girl. Get him. So many places you go, and I want y'all to stop if y'all doing it out there. Quit fighting each other. Love each other. Applaud each other. Tell each other how wonderful you are. God got a place for all of us. Baby, you can't take my place. And if you really knew me, you wouldn't want to be me. Crazy! Look, I need to tell y'all that God has been so good to me. Those of you who know my story, I've had 5 strokes. Had. God has been so good. Five strokes, brain tumor. I live with that every day. You need to know that right now, they're going to be calling again because I asked them to stop calling me. Look, Duke University in North Carolina does a study on me. Because I had the one before that, I had a double aneurysm. Y'all hear me say double aneurysm? You hear the doctor say no walking? She'll never walk again. She won't talk. I'm legally paralyzed on my right side. I walk on a leg. This leg to me feels like a piece of wood. Y'all don't see me like, honey, I'll hop in Jesus' name. What? You have to watch me closely to see I got the limb. Well, let me tell you what else I got. I got faith. Yeah. I got God. And I laugh. Yolanda sitting over there, she came to visit me. She had bust out crying. I look like somebody had come in and put up a spider web. There's so many tubes. I look, 1, 2, 3, 4. You know how they said if people was on a ventilator when they had COVID? A machine was breathing for me. That's the kind of God I serve. Woo! So when I get up here and I start to tell God thank you, and I'm down there on that prayer line and I get to Kate Helfitz, don't try to, let me tell y'all this, you can't cool off nobody shall no little old fan. Don't cool me off, just let me enjoy Jesus. God is so good to us. I dare not tell somebody how good he is. I told you about that sale at Macy's. I told you how good that peach cobbler was. I got a little man I work with. He swore I make the best cornbread in town. What? Reverend, I really cook. He always mess with these women like we don't still cook. Oh, I am an old woman now. No wonder you said that. You're right. Look. We need to love on each other. We need to tell each other how important you are. You know the day how they was when D introduced me. Evangelist Collins, let me call you D. But that's my friend, I call her D. When Evangelist Collins introduced me, she said, she'll take her hair. I didn't mean to take my hair off that day. I promise y'all I didn't mean to take my wig off. Look. That messed Brother John Williams up. He said, my daddy's a preacher. I've been in church for years. Now, I seen folks shout out of their wig. I seen the wig fall. I ain't never seen anybody take their wig off on purpose. But I needed to show someone with that bald head I had. I was going through radiation at that time. And I did it to show somebody. You don't know who you're sitting next to, what they going through, sitting there looking all pretty like everything fine. And I snatched that hair off. Y'all, you could hear a pin drop in here. But I needed somebody to know that you could be sitting next to somebody going through something you don't know. And then I said, when I got off, thought, did I really do that? Took my good hair off. Look. But do you know what happened? And one of the young ladies is here now. Stand up, babe. I ain't playing. Wait, y'all, listen. You don't know why you're doing it. She saw us online, and she said, if that church, if those people are that real, out, she came and joined the church. Amen. Her and her daughter. Now, I didn't know why I took my wig off. I won't do it again. I'll keep this on. This is a good one, too. Now, look. I don't know what possessed me to take my hair. I'm not going to do that. Wait a minute. 2 weeks later, I'm out there shouting, just got happy. They were singing Worth. I got to shout. Looked at the man and said, excuse me, ma'am. I said, yeah? Is that your eyelash? I done shouted all out my eyelashes. So I'm going to tell y'all this. Sometimes you got to get ugly for Jesus. But what I do want to tell y'all know I'm crazy as I can be. I've been crazy all my life. But you know, more than that, you need to know I'm crazy about Jesus. I'm just cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs crazy about Jesus. Because y'all know what he did. He got Gilligan off that island. Look here. Look, let me tell y'all something. Reverend Hart, you're not gonna like Reverend Hart. You're not gonna like him. Reverend Hart. That's my cheerleader right there. Here, he always cheering me on. Thank you, Reverend Hart. Look, God has been so good to me. If you live through 5 strokes and you hear doctors here, there, every time, hear a doctor there talking to everyone, she's not gonna make it. Y'all better call. Ask my son how many times they said, y'all better call everybody in. She's not going to make it. Look, all this is paralyzed. Couldn't do nothing. Honey, I praised him on the left side. Yes, I am. I praised him on the left side. And that's the kind of faith you better have. They were laughing. Wednesday, I had a stroke. Guess where I was Sunday? In here praising God with one hand. I don't care what go down in my life. Jesus is going to pick me up. And you better start having that kind of faith, too. If you don't know nothing, anything, you know, I miss Brother Gaston. Ooh, woo, I miss him. Because if I'd have said you don't know nothing, he'd have, he cringe when you mess up them double negatives. I'm from the country, y'all. Waco, Texas. What? Look, if you don't know anything about me from this day forward, know that I love God. I love you. And I want the people of God to have all of God. I don't want you to get part of God and miss anything he has for you. I want you to get all your blessings, everything he has for you. And the way you do that, get real with God. He'll get real with you. We don't need to be doing the church hokey pokey. Y'all hear me? I love you. Now, DJ, drop that beat. Look, it's time. I want y'all to see what my heart is, the thing I have on my heart. I have great faith. Everything I start praying for, it happens. And this is something I saw on this week. I want y'all to know this is where my heart is now, and I want the women to pray. The Bible says to call for the mourning women, call for the cunning women. We need to start praying. This is not Women's Day by accident that I'm here speaking. Women, I know the reason this country, the reason so many places are so messed up is because we are not doing, ladies, what we are called to do. The Bible says that we, the women, he's appointed us to be calling to stop the bloodshed in the streets. The Bible says that. That's our job, to be praying women, to do what we're supposed to. We're supposed to say, ooh, another shooting? Ooh, get on your knees. Oh, God, please stop the madness. God, please, I'm defending. That's what I do. God, you know what is happening so much? It's become commonplace. Oh, another shooting. Oh, Devil, not up in here. Devil, I cancel your very assignment. That's the devil. Let it be one after another. So we call it commonplace. Please, if you don't hear anything else I say, women, it's time for us to go to war against all this foolishness. It's time for us to do what God has called us to do. Pray, believe, trust in a God that can. Pray, believe, and trust in a God who can and will answer our prayer. Too much. Losing our young men. Too many. Too often. Oh, my God. We need to pray and get it right. This happened in Kansas City, Thursday, April 13th. Did you hear what they said? They said, "We love you, Ralph."
We love you, Ralph. 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 We love you, Ralph.
Now, what I want you to see is the diversity of the crowd. Black, white. Well, guess who they were? Staley High School children. It was over 1,500 children got together. A young man, a young black man, rang the doorbell, tried to go pick up his brothers from the house, rang the wrong doorbell, and the man shot him twice. And you know, he a miracle. He's sitting there talking about it. He shot him in the head. But what I want you to see is young people. I'm tired of us talking about hating each other. I'm so tired of politicians hating on people and people hating on people and the Jews do this and so-and-so do that. I want us, women, y'all hear me. This is where it gets started in the home. We teach our children love, love, love. They were yelling, "We love you, Ralph." They weren't yelling justice for this, justice for that. That was part of it. The main thing they were saying, the young people, I believe, are going to get us out of this hatred mess. Stop hating on each other. Yes, we're different. Yes, we eat different food. Yes, we go to different churches. Yes, we talk about different things. Yes, we have, but we love each other. My mother taught us that people are people, and whatever color they are, fools come in all colors. Stop hating on people. But I wanted you all to see that because I believe we got hope. My next thing that I'm really, really trusting God for is that our country learn to love again, that we learn to love each other. And I believe it's going to start with those young people. I believe when the old folk die out with that mess that they were taught, these people, some of them, matter of fact, are too inclusive. But guess what? They're not hating on each other. We have to learn to love each other. I remember in our day, let me tell you how I learned respect. I was 5 years old the first day I got respect everybody. Was a little man in our neighborhood called Duck Barnes. Who named the child Duck? I don't know. But his name was Duck Barnes. And then that day, I'm in San Angelo, Texas, and he going down the alley, overalls on, a shirt. And here me and my brother, I said, "Hi, Mr. Barnes. Hi, Mr. Barnes." Another kid, "Hey, ain't nobody but Duck. You ain't got to call him Mr. Barnes." And a little kid, a little boy, threw a rock at a grown man. Oh, y'all felt that too, didn't you? I went, "Mama, Mama, Lord have mercy." Remember the one named Kurt Autry? He was the preacher's kid too. Remember, he was bad. He was the preacher's son. Kurt picked up a rock and threw it. Oh, that ain't nobody with Duck Barnes. He just a hobo. Guess what? That day I learned respect. I said, "Mama, Kurt took a rock and he threw it and hit Mr. Barnes." He said, "What? Mama, they said we don't have to call him Mr. Barnes. We can just say, 'Hey, Duck.'" She said, "I wish you would. I wish you would call a grown man by his first name." She said, "That is a grown man. He got a heart. He got a mouth. He got needs just like everybody else. Just because we live in this house and we know what we're going to eat every day, don't you dare." I learned that from a 5-year-old child. And from that day forward, I've been feeding homeless, doing what we do at my auntie's funeral yesterday. They were saying how we used to go to the park on Sunday. Guess what? We're talking about 1967, 68. My mama and us, we would go to the park at 10th at Speedway and Stone. Well, they got the park got a name now. We just call it the park, okay? And we would take out every Easter. You got an Easter outfit and then an Easter outfit to play. Y'all ever do that? You got some shorts? What? Got a new set of shorts and an Easter outfit. And we go to the park every Easter. My mom had the food, take the pots up there to the park, warm it up, and feed the people in the park. Since the 1960s, my Aunt Dorothy that you see, they would take their stuff and they went to call Catalina Park on 2nd right there and 4th. It was in us. It's in our DNA. I'm not kidding y'all. I counted the other day, I was talking to my sister Hattie. I said, you know what? We had so many folk in and out of our house. My mama raised us, a single woman, got divorced early, raised us. And I said, do you know I counted the other day 37 people that had to live with us at one time or another? My mama ain't had nothing. And she sharing nothing. Ain't she got a nerve? She sure did. And guess what she did? She left that for me, for my son, for everybody in our family. If we don't have anything else, we got a loving spirit and we know how to share. And we know how to care for people. And I'm asking y'all today, if you don't get anything else I got, get my faith. How you like the doctor tell you 5 times you're not going to make it? Look at here. I had a stroke so bad that my whole face twisted to the right side. My left side sat over here. I had to eat with my face this way. Mm-mm. Tell me that's not a God. Wait! I didn't get like sister girl here, no immediate. A year my face stayed over there. Looked like Quasimodo from the ghetto. But God. God has been so good to me. I've been in a wheelchair, a walker, on the cane. They say, you're not good. When I went to the doctor to fill in my paper, so you know how you get the handicap sticker? He said, whose name do I put up here as the driver? I said, oh, put my name on there. He said, no, I need the name for who to drive, who be driving the car. I said, I will. He said, oh, honey, I'm sorry. They didn't tell you that right leg of yours, honey, it's so bad. I don't think you'll ever be able to drive again. Well, you should have told me when I drove up here. I just need you to do the paper. I've been driving 3 months. He said, that right leg, you won't ever be able to drive again. Well, you sure should have told me. Because I trusted God, and I got behind. First, I couldn't drive. I couldn't. And to this day, I have to work to feel the pedal. All this leg just dead as it can be. Well, guess what is a lie? The bottom of my foot. What you got to feel to press the pedal? The bottom of your foot. When I go to doctor, they stick pins all in my leg. I don't feel a thing. Don't you touch the bottom of my foot, I'll kick him to the moon. But God is a good God. You need to know, on last month, the people called from Duke University. You know what I told them? They called my granddaughter. So, Raisha Cho, we're trying to check on your grandmother, Doretta Elliott. We wanted a welfare check. How is she? I said, give me that phone. Let me tell y'all something. I'm alive and well, loving Jesus. They said, man, I said, why do y'all keep calling her? But ma'am, your sister girl got on the phone. It's just a minute, ma'am. It's on a recording. She took the recorder. Girl, people don't be living like she had to tell the truth. Do you know that usually we have to call a relative? They can't talk anymore. They don't walk. They don't. And I realized how blessed I am. I knew it. But you know how when Duke University doing a study on me, I said, you tell them to understudy me because I'm okay. Call somebody who need them. I got Jesus. And I'm going to keep Jesus. So if y'all don't know anything else I said today, please stop doing the church hokey pokey. Get God right in your life. Have faith. Start a prayer life, a real prayer life. I told y'all before, too. I didn't have nothing to tell God because I wasn't talking to him. He loves you. He wants to hear from you. Get your life together and have faith in God. What do you do in the midst of your situation? Do you trust God? What are you going to do? I asked you today, put God in your life, because truly, we have come this far by faith.
Hallelujah. Come on, give the Lord a hand clap of praise for this woman of God, amen, who has preached the word of God to the people of God and the house of God and to those online as well. Amen. She had like 5 sermons in that sermon. Amen. Amen. All that good, rich information, powerful testimonies. She is literally a walking miracle. If you want to see what a miracle looks like, you see a walking miracle. We listen to a walking miracle today. You know, it's easy to talk about faith in God when you got a lot of money, you got good health and all these things going for you. But when your back is up against the wall, you're laying flat on your bed,
and the doctors have given up hope on you. That's when your real faith gonna kick in, amen? That's when you really realize that God is real, amen. As we're standing, we're going to extend the invitation. Maybe there's somebody here, you do not know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and maybe you've been doing the church hokey pokey, and maybe you need to make a decision on today. Maybe you've been coming to church for a while. You need to make a decision today. Today, I'm going to give my life to Christ. Today, I'm going to unite with this church, and I want to grow in my faith. So if you need special prayer, you can come to my left. If you need special prayer, maybe you're struggling with some things, you got some issues in your life that you're dealing with, you can come to my left. And if you're here and maybe you're not saved, you can come to my right and they will explain to you the plan of salvation. Or maybe you're saved but you don't have a church home, you can come to my right if the Lord has spoken to your heart about this church. And I like what Evangelist Elliott said about diversity, because when you look around this church, you see diversity. And we're learning to get along with each other and love each other because we're all God's children. We're all different. We're all unique. Amen. And there's room for all of us. Amen. At the foot of the cross, God can use all of our gifts and talents for his glory and for the upbuilding of his kingdom. So you can come to my left if you need special prayer. To my right, if you want to unite with this church family or give your life to Christ, you can come as the choir sings. We offer Christ to you. Can still come. We offer Christ to you. Not just church membership, we offer Christ to you. He is the Savior. You may be seated. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is moving in our midst. Amen. That's why we are taking our time and not rushing our service, because the Spirit of God is working on the hearts of people, and we want to give God time to work. Amen. Amen. There are things that are going on in our lives that we can't handle, but we got to give those things to God and let God work in us and work through us. Amen. Oftentimes when we go to church, we want to have a quick drive-through service. But it takes time to get into the presence of God and let your spirit be still before him and let him work on you. Never want to rush the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Truly, we thank God for the message on today. As they wrap things up at the altar, amen, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise for the woman of God. Amen. On today. Amen. Amen. Somebody said that preaching is God speaking through human personality. Amen. And we all have a different personality. And so we should not expect one person to preach like another person. We all have our own unique style, our own unique personality. And when we try to preach like somebody else, we're not being authentic and genuine. Amen. We need to use the gifts and talent that God has given us, filtered through our personality. Amen. Amen. Because when you read the book of Jeremiah, it's different from the book of Isaiah. Come on, somebody. Matthew's gospel is different from Luke's gospel. Mark's gospel is different from John's gospel. Amen. Because God gave them each a special revelation of him so that they could communicate it to the world. Amen. And I just praise God for the mighty women of God here at Rise and Star. Amen. We are truly blessed to have such awesome vessels right here in our midst. I think my last count, we got something like 25 to 30 associate ministers here at Rise and Star. What a blessing. Some churches don't even have that many members, and we got that many preachers. Come on. We got a lot to be grateful for. Amen. And I really praise God for these ministers, especially our women, because they have such a commitment to Christ. Amen. And many of them have advanced degrees in ministry and stuff. Amen. Master's divinity and all that stuff. But they're still humble, and they follow leadership, and they don't rebel and think they know more than the pastor and stuff. I admire their humility in them, in spite of their education, in spite of their giftedness. They still humble. And that's what it takes for God to use you, humility, amen? Amen. I believe Doretta said she was like 13 in her class out of 472. And some of us were 471 and we arrogant. Come on. You know, people just kill me how full of they are of themselves. I'm like, my God, get a clue. Amen. But God is looking for humble vessels. Amen. I heard Bishop Jake say something. He said that you can never be too small for God to use you. He said, but you can be too big for God to use you. God is looking for empty vessels so he can fill that vessel with himself so that he can use you for his glory. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much. God bless you. This time we're going to turn it over to the president of our women's ministry, Sister Flemings. Amen. Come on, Sister Martha Fleming. Amen.
Try it again. There we go. We have had a wonderful, wonderful time in the Lord. This is our annual Women's Day program. But before we go there, last week on Saturday, we had a Women's Day tea luncheon, and we called it a fun day. And we really had fun because we had several speakers. Well, actually, they were surprise guests, and no one knew who they were until they got there the morning of. And we had this young lady, Jordan Hart, which we'd like to thank her very much because she did an awesome job. And Reverend Kim McDowell, we thank you so much, was our second speaker. And you saw the pictures on the video. Those were pictures that were taken at the tea, and it was just a great time in the Lord, the fellowshipping, getting to know each other. And this is what God wants us to do. Once we get to know, fellowship with each other in the church, once we get to know each other, then we go out, we share this, the word of God, with others, non-believers. And that's exactly what Rising Star is doing. And we, not only that, we have the women's group, we have Bible study classes, we have group discussions, and we give back to our community through our blessing bags for the homeless during the park, in the park, and this is every Thanksgiving morning, and we've done it for many years, and we continue to do it. And our women also help with the food baskets, with the Utterback food pantry, and we also supply school supplies to our students, our youth here at Rising Star. So we just had an amazing time, and the women's ministry is all about serving. It's nothing about me, you, it's about all about God. So we get together and we spread the word that God wants us to spread.
Amen.
And we just wanted to thank our program helpers with the tea. Everyone on the program did an excellent job. Everything, the food was great. The fellowship and the games were fun. So we thank those helpers with that. And right now our service, none other, Evangelist Doretta Elliott. You did a super job. An amazing job, and we just thank God for you because each and every day,
thank you.
He does something special in our lives. And so, Sister Lewis, thank you, Sister.
Oh, thank you.
Sister Lewis, we would just like to thank you
for who you are, just a genuine person, loving, kind, and always helping. Always, always helping out. And right now we know we come to you because we know that God is able all the time to take care of you as well. And to the beautiful women, look at all these, wow. Beautiful women, thank you so very much because we love you and we thank you for what you do, and you're all servants of God and you do other things in the church as well. So we appreciate that from you. Right now, we just wanted to take some time to actually point out a couple of people who've been serving and doing things, maybe behind the scene, things that we don't know about, but we learn about them. So to those people, if you're here, Tammy Brown. Okay. Kim Howard, we'd like to. Okay. Kim Howard. Next. Kim Howard. Janelle Lewis. Janelle. We'd like to thank you so much for all you do. God bless you. We love you. And Sister Pennywell. Yeah. Surprise. Sister Pennywell, we just thank you for all you do. And from the women's ministry, we love you and we say God bless you and continue to do what you do.
My heavenly Father, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Sister Tammy.
Thank you.
God bless you. Sister Antoinette Williams, we know she's not here right now. But God bless you. Thank you, our pastor, Pastor Lewis, and our First Lady. Sister Lewis, we thank you for all that you do for the women's department and for most of all for the church. And then the women's department, we love you very much, and we just say continue. We continue to pray and for each other as well. God bless you.
All right, let's give it up for the women. Amen. Evangelist Elliott. You got a presentation? Okay.
I want to say.
A little long for the sisters.
Oh, yeah. You know we long-winded, Rev. Look, I've always wanted to do this. I just want you to slow down. Look. I just want to see what you do. I talk real slow. When we get. See? She can do it. Look. I want you all to know that we have the best women's president. She is so humble. She is so caring. She is so loving. Ladies, can we stand to our feet just to tell God thank you for Sister Fleming? We thank you. I want her to give her flowers while she can smell them.
Praise the Lord. I just got this joke with myself. You know I had knee surgery, everybody. You can have a seat. Thank you. You know I had knee surgery, and I've been wearing those shoes. I had those shoes for almost 15 years, and I said, God, I'm going to get in those shoes. And I said, okay, so Amos know I go through 3 changes every Sunday morning. So I had something teal green because they go with beige. I had something beige. They go with beige. I had this orange. And God said, you know what? Don't get in those shoes. I said, no, Lord, you have been so good. I'm getting in those shoes. But once I sat down in the chair, I said, Lord, you know, God got a sense of humor. I said, Lord, I can't get up. And God, I'm like, God, help me, Jesus, please. I'm not trying to be rude. Help me. He say, take them off. So I took off my shoes. And so I just wanted to say thank you. Two awesome women. Will you two come forward, please? We want to bless you too. You know, Doretta is so right. Evangelist Doretta is so right. I know Doretta since we first started at her mom's house. She is so right. Her mom took us in as a son and daughter. She just was there for all my kids. And I just love them. I love your mom. I love your spirit. I love the word that God has given you. And we just wanted to say, Rising Star folks, wanted to say to you too that we just love you so dearly. We thank God that you are servants. We thank God that you don't want to be served. We thank God for your beautiful spirit. And most of all, we thank God because you are warriors for the Lord. And so I just wanted to give you some love. And we just appreciate you as women of this church. You are our minister, our women minister. And we praise you and we thank God for your both of your spirit. They like peanut butter and jelly. And we thank God for both of you. Thank you so much for your beautiful service. Thank you. And the other gift is from Lisa. Okay. Lisa Keaton wanted to give you also something special, too. Yeah. Can we hide behind this so they won't see my stockings? Yeah.
The middle. You're fine. She wants to see her feet. She said, you won't get your feet.
You want to take my feet?
Yes. There's a basket in the corner on the side, but not right now.
All right, Joe, I'm counting on you.
Thank you.
This is for Lisa, too.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Love you. Ooh, thank you. Awesome word. Okay, thank you. There is one other thing, and it's for our Rising Star sick and shut in. These are the women who have been hospitalized, and they are not here today, but we just wanted to let you know that these baskets are from the women's department, and they will be going to Sister Aubrey Gaston, Sister Von Seal, Sister Terry Davis, and there's one other. C.D. George. So they will be receiving these. I have the names. This is just a sample of what they will be receiving. But that's one other thing that the Women's Department here at Rising Star, we do take care of our sick and shut-in as well. And we know that we have a care ministry, but we also do the same. Thank you so much.
Amen. I think I heard Toby playing Let the Church Say Amen earlier. He transitioned. Amen. Thank you for your patience on today. Amen. And it's just good to be in the house of the Lord with the people of God. Amen. Amen. Some of my ex-clubbing people and ex-concert people, you know, you used to party until they had to, like, run you out of the place. Some of y'all remember that? They used to tell you, you don't have to go home, but you got to get up out of here. And you'll leave one club and go to another club. Anybody know? All right. Amen. So we're getting ready to go. Go ahead and stand. Praise God for our First Lady and all of our ladies here. Such a jewel, such a blessing. Amen. 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 If you visiting for the first time, I'd like to meet you, okay? If you just hang around and meet me right here if you're visiting for the first time. I just want to know your name and where you're from. And let me just say this for any of the guys out there who may be single and you're looking for a wife, make sure you read about the virtuous woman in Proverbs. Amen. Amen. Because as I was dating, I wrote Sister Lua's name by that passage. And she was the epitome of a virtuous woman. And I knew that she would be a blessing to my ministry and to my children and everything that I would do in life. So make sure you do that. Amen. Amen. Beautiful on the outside and the inside. Amen. Through and through. What a jewel. And then that's my little mini me. Let's sure say amen. Say it one more time, the whole church, everybody, even those online. Hallelujah. Bless your name, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So let the church. God bless you. Have a blessed week, and hopefully we'll see you next week right back here. Amen. First time guest, if you would just come down front real quick and let me holler at you.
Greetings from Pastor Amos and First Lady Lewis and our Rising Star family. If you would like to get connected with information about various ministries, church, and community events, check our Facebook page and website at www.risingstarbaptist.org or call the church office. If you need your member information, we can assist with that too. Join us online or in person for our 10 a.m. worship service.
Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Amos L. Lewis, the senior pastor of the Rising Star Missionary Baptist Church. I would like to personally invite you to our 10 a.m. worship service. We are a multicultural, multi-generational church.
There is room for the whole family. Rising Star provides child care and youth church for ages 0 through 18.
So we would love for you to come and join us because we are a church where everyone is welcome. We are a local church with a global reach. We look forward to seeing you and meeting you. God bless you.
Thank you for joining Rising Star Baptist Church for our Sunday morning worship. We pray that this message renews your spirit, transforms your daily life, and strengthens your walk with Christ. If this message has touched you, share it with others. We look forward to seeing you next week. But in the meantime, let's stay connected. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We thank you for helping Rising Star become a local church with a global reach. Have a blessed week.